What's up, guys? Welcome to the first episode in this Madden franchise. Gonna be rebuilding the Jacksonville Jaguars. They've not got a bad team. Obviously not the best team. But as we all know, they do have what they believe to be their franchise quarterback moving forwards. I'm going to start right at season start of the new season. I'm not going to bother with pre-season in this first year. I will do going forwards, but for the first season I'm just going to jump straight into the season. We can have a look at the team for this upcoming season. Obviously Trevor Lawrence is going to be our starting quarterback, potentially being the franchise. Now there's no plans to replace him. Obviously there's no need to replace him anytime soon, but we'll have to see how he goes as our franchise QB. Hopefully that'll be fine. James Robinson and rookie ETN, we're pretty set, I would say, for running backs. Again, that's something I don't think we're going to be needing to look at any point for the foreseeable, which is really good, especially when you look at their contracts, because they're both a 1 year and a rookie. We've got some good contracts going there, so that's all good. Our receiver, it's a bit of a shame that Marvin Jones is our best receiver, especially at 31, so we will need to look to replace him going forwards. DJ Chark and LaVisca Chenault will be, certainly looks to be, the future receivers of the team, but we're certainly going to have to build a receiving core around them. Marvin Jones being our best receiver is good for this year, but being 31, obviously he's not going to be around for too long. Tight end is definitely something we're going to need to look at. Dan Arnold's our best. He's 26. And everybody else is worse. So we will eventually need to try and find a tight end. So we'll see what's available in free agency at the end of the season, and even potentially during the season, what's around. Probably look to the draft for those, though. Left tackle, we're probably going to need to look at. And that's something that I'll look to probably build through the draft, I would imagine. Unless something amazing crops up in free agency. But yeah, left tackle is definitely something we'll look at in the draft. Now, left guard, we're eventually going to need to look at. Hopefully, Barch can grow to be a decent one. But as of now, with only being 29, get a good couple of years out of him while we build a good left guard, so that's not really a worry at any point. Same with the center, Brandon Linder, won't need to look to him. We'll need a better backup and look to build one, but yeah, left guard and center is set for a good couple of years, which is always handy. Definitely gonna need a right guard. And be something we'll address going into the off season. Because not only is he only a 75 overall, but he's 29 as well. So it'll be okay for the season going forwards, but not what we need. And then right tackle. He's young, so he could grow into a good one. So it's something we'll look at as the season progresses. Might be something we need to address. Might not, might turn out that we've actually got a pretty good right tackle there. But yeah, that's one we're really gonna have to, we'll see how the season plays out for him. On the edges, they're not too bad. Need to look at as it's okay going into the season, but obviously we're going to want a lot better than that to make a Super Bowl contender. Definitely going to need to have a look at this one. This really isn't good enough. With Robertson, Harris would probably be our starter there. Both the same age, both experience, but he fixed the scheme, so yeah, we'll go with him. Defensive tackle, definitely gonna need defensive tackle, so we're just gonna need an entire line, an entire D line is gonna need to be built. I'm not going to be able to do anything without that, but not expecting to do much this year anyway. Hopefully get some good draft classes. And so yeah, outside linebackers, Clavon, Clavon Chason, I don't know, I've probably absolutely decimated that name. I'd probably just call him by number rather than name, because I haven't a clue. He's only 1 year in, he looks to have some good stats, and he might be a good outside linebacker to have for the future. He'll be one to keep an eye on. And we'll see how he builds. Middle linebacker, we're set with Miles Jack. We'll have to look and see what we've got left on his contract eventually, but yeah, I think we'll be set. He's only 25, so we'll be set at linebacker for him. Josh Allen, completely forgot the Jags had Josh Allen. But yes, only two years in, fits the scheme. We're set there. So between Josh Allen and Miles Jack, we're going to be building our defense around those two. Corner, we've got Shaquille Griffin. Being 26, that's not bad, actually. We'll look to get him some help. Tyson Campbell, rookie, will keep an eye on him and see how he goes over the season. But yeah, I think we could be good at corner if Tyson Campbell is any good. Free safety is a definite need. That's not going to cut it. I mean, I know wing guard's only 24, so I doubt he's going to be anything special, but we'll keep an eye on him. But yeah, I think free safety is going to be a huge piece we need to look at, and definitely support safety, strong safety. That's really not going to do. So yeah, we're going to need strong safeties and free safeties, D-line, tight end, left tackle and right guard, and we'll be keeping an eye on the right tackle. And then these are our draft picks for 2022. Got quite a few of them, to be fair. So we've got 2 7th, 2 6th, 2 5th, a 4th, a 3rd, a 2nd, and a 1st. Might make some moves, see if we can move up again. Maybe get a couple of first rounders. Try and get a 2nd first rounder, maybe, and potentially a second round. Try and help rebuild, but that's our squad going forward, and we'll have to see how that goes. I'll look at the team schedule. So got the Texans now. I don't see why that can't be a win. They are overall worse than us. Obviously, we don't know how that's going to translate into the game. But, yeah, all right, so I would say there's one win going in. So, for the first 6 weeks, we've got a bye week in week 7. So, we've got the Texans. Broncos will be a tough game. That one, I think, can go either way. So, potentially 2. Cardinals. Will probably be a bit too good for us, I believe. Bengals will have too much. Titans, I think, well and truly, they're one of the best. And then the Dolphins, I think they're one of those teams that are going to be in and around us. So going into our bye week, we could easily have 3 wins there. I would certainly be looking at 2, the Texans and the Dolphins being wins. They're the ones that I think we should be winning. So that'll give us 2, and the Broncos potentially a 3rd win. And then coming out of the bye week for the second half of the season for us anyway. Seahawks, Bills, Colts, Niners, I think we'll all have a bit too much. Falcons will probably have a bit too much, although they're not the team they once were. I still think they might have a bit too much for this team this year. And then the Rams and the Titans. So yeah, I think there's a lot of losses, and then that would pretty much determine the ending. But I think a 3rd win, potentially a 4th win, if we can beat the Broncos, as we play the Texans again, the Jets a potential, and the Patriots and Colts. So yeah, 4-5 win season this year I think could be good, which would give us a top 5 pick in the first 2 in the first round. I think that would be a good season. So we'll go into setting the goals, and I'll look at 4 wins for the year. I don't think we're going to get much more than that. As I said, probably 5 if we're lucky. But we got a couple of press conferences to do here. One setting out the coming up. And they're just asking, it's the opening day of the week and a fresh start for every team around the league, and we'll be facing the Texans. What's going to be key to the victory here? I think with a rookie QB, young receiving and running back group, I think we're going to have to hold you starting defense, hold them to minimal points, keep them off the board. Is going to be the key to winning this game. And I think we're going to have to stuff the run, because other than Brandon Cooks, they haven't really got anything going forward. I think David Johnson's good enough running back, but with Deshaun Watson, hoop and scramble. I think that's going to make it. That's going to make it that little bit more difficult. So I'm not. So yeah, I think defense is going to be the best way of winning this game. Now we're talking about Trevor Lawrence here. Tough for rookies early on. What am I expecting from him? I'm not really expecting anything of him. I just want him to show flashes. Show me what he can do. Obviously, being the number one overall pick, everybody's going to be expecting him to dominate early. And I think as a rookie QB, that can be difficult. So show flashes. Just show something. And so the target is to get to... get two passing touchdowns, which will be good. This will be a longer episode than the rest of them will be, being that we're doing the setup of it all, and then moving forward, as I say, it will just be the weekly strategies and the gameplay itself, whereas this one is obviously setting up the scouting, setting up, yeah, looking through the team and the roster, looking at the schedule and all of that. So going forward, this will be the longest episode I do, other than potentially I might do a draft one, which would be one in itself. That might be a longer one. We'll see how much I know about the players at the time. But yeah, this episode here will probably be the longest that we do for now, and then moving forward, it'll just be, we'll just be doing the normal stuff of setting up our strategy and playing the game itself. So yes, this is going to be a longer one, please bear with me on that, but we will sort that going forwards. So we don't need to worry too much. Like I say, if you are starting to get slightly bored so far, we are going to move into all of these things, and we'll keep them going, keep them moving properly going forwards. But now we'll sort out the strategy, and our game plan is to limit the run. I don't know if we should try and stop him, Deshaun Watson, from scrambling. We'll defend the inside run. We can make halftime adjustments in the game. We'll see how it's going, but we'll start off with the run. That's probably the best thing. Sorting out the practice reps. I'm only going to do half pads because I don't want people getting injured, and I am going to split the reps between the starters and the backups, just because, again, I don't want people getting injured. If I can avoid injuries as much as possible and fatigue as much as possible, that is going to be the best thing. I mean, they do say they pass more often than they run. Should I defend them? No, we'll stick with defending the run. Now for our offense, it says throw it deep, but we got a, it says blitz counter. Do you know what, we'll throw it deep. We'll take the computer recommendation, we'll take our coach's recommendation, and we'll just throw it deep. And as with the defense, we're gonna go half pads and we're gonna split the reps. Again, it's all about injuries. We don't want them getting too injured. They typically go zone coverage, so they either zone coverage or they zone blitz, so that'll be something to keep an eye on.
This is your team. Choose focus players each week.
We'll set the goals for the week. I think throwing two passing touchdowns is fine. Recovering three fumbles might be a bit much, but we'll stick with it and we'll look. That seems good to me. And my focus players, I'm going to keep on the rookies that were drafted this year. Because obviously I've got a feeling Tyson Campbell might be our cornerback of the future. Obviously, Etienne and Robinson's going to be, should be a good combo at running back. And, well, Trevor Lawrence should be our franchise QB. So we really want the best we can get for them so that we can upgrade them better. Got a few upgrades here, so just kill Quarterman. Probably won't play much, but upgrading here, getting some pass coverage. Brady gets his acceleration, which really helps. And then Josh Allen, outside linebackers coming off the edge. We do want him to be quick. I'll do speed rusher for now, and we'll look at other bits like coverage and that. I mean, we get a plus one coverage there anyway. Strength, tackle, zone coverage, and finesse moves. That's all right then. All of those help. Okay, so now we've gotten all of that out of the way, we are going to jump into the first game of the season, where we're going to take on the Houston Texans. It's going to be interesting. So any of you watching that aren't great at this game, you'll at least be able to watch somebody else suck at it. Come on. He can't tackle. It's gone for a touchdown right off the bat. So yeah, you're all going to feel a lot better about your playing abilities when watching this. And those arguing at this game are going to probably just cry at how bad I am. I don't know how this one wasn't the tackle for number 25. Happy days. Hold them to 75 rushing yards is the target. And I think they've got him that. 71 already in one play. So I've got 4 yards. I've got to contain him to 4 rushing yards for the rest of the game. I think we can kiss goodbye to that. It's gone. So let's see what our offense can do then. So Trevor Lawrence gets his first snap, and there's no blocking. Happy days.
Charles, a look there at the Jaguars draft class for 2021, and no question, this will all be judged by how Trevor Lawrence performs.
So,
but they were also able to pick up some potential
wasn't
going to
be
blocks later on.
Great game, but there's Chenault Jr. with the catch for our first down, first catch of Trevor Lawrence's career. 17 yards.
In the pick from the Jalen Ramsey trade, and then in some serendipity in the second round, they
so can keep on
Tyson
going.
Campbell, who they hope can replace Jalen Ramsey, as well as a big offensive tackle in Stanford's Walker Little.
And he's intercepted. Desmond King picks brilliant. Two pass attempts. 17-yard gain and a pick.
What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then
there's,
you get the interception. Just
there's me saying you should be able to get a win out of this one. That's not going to work.
You would think they might
looking
be
great.
Extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well, and they took the shot downfield. They were more than prepared for that one.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Jim thought he had a step on that one. I'm not sure how it got picked, but he only defended it at least.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line
defended
is
it at least, so that wasn't a completion. See if we can get some pressure on him. No, enough pressure to make him throw it away. So 4th and 9, we get it. 3 and out. That's better. The offense can do what the defense has just done. Not a good first start, but have a better go. That's going to be a hold, isn't it? Hello. Look in the back. That's not good. Okay. Now we're backed up even more.
Does he go safe now, or does he continue to run the full game plan?
Now Lawrence to throw.
There's a completion.
Dan Arnold, the tight end.
Dan Arnold. Let's go. Second and 9. That's manageable. That's fine. Don't mind that. And Chenault Jr. with another catch and another first down. And we are moving. This is what we like to see. Let's go. I am running the Carolina playbook.
We sure have seen some good ones. We
certainly. How has he picked that? I've got that. I'm a little lost for words here, to be honest. Okay, no, I wasn't throwing to him. Throwing Dan. All right, we'll keep on him. Ball's in the air. Great ball. Somehow. This isn't going to go well.
They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And he's going
to. At least we've got a stop there. But they're already over 82 rushing yards, so that's that target gone.
Johnson again.
A big tackle there. Third and goal. They're at the 5 yard line.
Three, and now a much tougher third down looming. Watson now to throw.
And a sack.
Pressure gets him back at the 14.
Well done, Smoot.
Dwayne Smoot.
Big sack there.
Drops
him back to the 14 yard line, which doesn't make this a difficult. It's a chip shot, but it's 3 points, which is the main thing.
The kick by Fairburn is good.
And maybe try and get the run game going. Take the pressure off the throws. And there's a big run from Robinson. Getting 9 there. Oh, they're crediting him a 10. Second and inches. I'm going to be stupid and try and throw it.
Plus the intensity and the speed really up on opening week.
No, pick again. My words. Oh, wrap up. What's going on? It's almost like they know where the ball's going. I can't make a single throw.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty
Sean
good
Watson for
the way
to no, they're not giving him the touchdown.
Great later. Who would that be? Everyone Peyton Manning through 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How things turn out for him? I think okay, he's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
All right, there we go. And roughing the passer, no doubt, because the offense wouldn't make a, the CPU wouldn't make a holding penalty there. No, of course. So we're down by 17 already with 3 picks.
Not at all. When you put the ball in the end zone on a takeaway, take the points and keep moving. Fairbairn good with the extra point.
We really are just going to have to keep away from
early advantage now to Goodwin, 17
from throwing the ball.
They kick this one away, and they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
We're just going to have to keep away from throwing the ball because apparently the offense, the CPU knows what I'm what I'm playing. I don't know if he's got a hot route going either.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to
throw. Oh, he's sacked now. And as my receivers are even running into themselves. They're blocking each other. And I didn't even have time to throw a ball. The Texans are not this good. I know I said this was going to be tough, and I know I said we are one of the worst teams in the league. But we're making the Texans look like prime Patriots. We're making them look like they're the Kansas City Chiefs right now. Even with Deshaun Watson, they are not that good.
Got this into the hands of the tight end, Jordan.
I don't know whether I want to be a fly on the wall or not when they hear the explanation of how he, one of the bigger targets on the field, the tight end can be wide open and uncovered downfield. Who blew that aside?
I've just threw two of them. Jumped through the middle of them.
So the completion good for 6 yards, and it'll make it a second down. Well, Deshaun Watson, when you think about the toughest quarterbacks in the league, the game plan against...
Oh, no, no, big man managed to just not be touched and straight out to block me. Timed it perfectly just to block me.
That's not an issue at all. He has great touch delivering the football, but that mobility, that added dimension... Oh, when he escapes the pocket and those receivers find their
this
way
game's
open,
gonna drive short, me up. Oh no, he's just dived past him now.
Least,
tackling in this game is, I can tell already, is gonna drive me insane.
Happy with good solid yardage, he'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Second and five now, Watson.
And there's another rough in the passer, no doubt. Yep. It's fine. Just.
And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence.
Robinson with the catch. What? Who have we held this time? Oh, no, we're going to get a rough in the passer. So we'll take that. Gives us a first down.
So now a fresh set of downs. First and 10 after rough.
Let's see if we can run the ball, because, well, we certainly can't throw it.
Lawrence with the handoff to Robinson.
That's a good run.
He gets about six up to midfield.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense, finding a way
six
to create that
run.
Type of yardage.
Let's keep this going.
That'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
I need to get the run game going because, come on, shed his block just enough. Third and one. I think we could get this. The right play call.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play. Get my defense off the field.
I think we could do this. The run. There it is. And that's a huge gain. Huge gain from ETN. Let's go.
And that's a pleasing run there by Travis ETN. And every time I see him carried, I think of the word mature. Why?
ETN with a big game. And I'm not with the run, with the passing at the moment. There's no need. Just going to have to run it at the moment. Our running backs are doing the job. There's no need to start throwing it, especially when he's throwing three picks in the first quarter. Some good blockage there. Probably the worst direction I could have run in. I think we're going to have to throw them fourth.
They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And there's a catch by the tight end, Arnold. And I'm just getting on the floor. Just want the first down. I don't want interceptions. I don't want fumbles at the moment.
On the run, it's Robinson.
There it is, Robinson! He's in! He's got to be in.
I think they like this last drive, they went three and out.
I mean, to be fair, Robinson deserves it, but should have given it to Robinson. Man, Hurts got nowhere there. When I say Robinson deserves it, ETN deserves it just as much. They both played a huge part in this. And there it is. That's easy. Finally, we've got a score.
Now the scoreboard still,
I don't think we should be sending people because they cost themselves some yardage there.
Now Watson on third and goal.
Sacks. Miles Jack there with the sack.
Miles Jack with a sack.
Holding them to three. Time out. Why am I letting the clock run? I forgot how low we was.
They've got to find a way to keep him upright so they can throw the football.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time.
As much as I want to run the ball, gonna have to try and get something going.
The kick by
throwing.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
We do need
to. Still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You gotta push it when
inaccurate.
You
could
never have enough points.
No reason.
That you face. And analytics will tell you.
And as the first number, as the number one overall pick, you can't be inaccurate on a pass like that.
Seems to be the front and the back end.
That'll do. Get around him. Get around him. It's fine.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync. Only way to play good defense.
Let's go.
Now Lawrence on first down.
Nice throw to the running back. And out of bounds. That's perfect.
Another completion there. Yeah, we think about the draft.
I think we are well within field goal range, so we don't want a pick.
But Charles, I would think maybe an extra burden too, or is that not that big of a deal at all?
It actually is.
Get a few more yards and just get out of bounds. That'll do. Nothing was open. They're able to cover us.
It becomes something that justifies why you were taken number one. You're fine with that. If you don't play well, it can be an albatross.
Second down and
there was nothing open there. They're able to just smother our receivers.
Lawrence will throw. And this one taken
in on
the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete.
Incomplete? Are you kidding me? Surely not. Of course I can't challenge it. Oh, I want a little bit of space here. Maybe he's, I don't know.
A little too far, it brings up third down. On the NFL scoreboard, second quarter in Nashville. They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass.
That looked
like
the
early lead there belonging to the Cardinals. Now Lawrence, Kyler Murray, a single touchdown pass to this quarterback. Well, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down.
I said I would take three, just about get three.
And that will move the deficit from 20 down to 17.
I said I would take three at the start of this.
He'll take the knee and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So we've reached
half. Do need some three and outs. We can't just
after three first half
can't give up touchdowns.
Strictly at the numbers here, you know what else happens to a team when you turn it over three times like that? It erodes confidence in you. And it erodes
confidence. That was a good game from Robinson. Second and one now.
What is going on here? And instead of playing for the team, they're playing angry and mad at their teammates.
The previous run good for nine. Here's second and a yard.
I like this if this is a run, to be fair. I like the run on this, especially second and one.
Again, it's Robinson.
That'll do. Robinson got me a
right
three there. More importantly, got me a first and 10.
Big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being
physical.
Should
be going to throw this.
A play fake for Robinson. Now Lawrence.
Get it out to the tight end. It's fine. Just get a completion.
And here we are on 3rd and 1. Be prepared. Brace yourself. Could be some contact going on.
On 3rd down, here's ETN. And trying to shake free, but ETN cannot.
Oh, come on. That was definitely a first down. Trevor Lawrence is a big boy. I think we can get the sneak here. That'll do.
He is tough and run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's
and there it is. Sneak. We get our first down. That's all that matters. Right now.
And taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Probably helps your confidence level on those 4th down sneaks.
That'll do.
A quarterback as tall as he is.
Yeah, you're talking about being able to extend at the end to make sure the ball gets to the first down marker, but also he has to be able to drop his hips and get down behind that offensive line in order to move forward, because if he just runs it straight up and down, you and I both know that they'll snap him backwards. Well done there. Well executed.
Great play for DJ.
DJ Shark. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard
line. Seven.
For the man in the middle, because abdominal tear. To look through all the clutter that's happening in front of him, diagnose a play.
Now, if we can get some good blocks here, this could work out quite well, to be fair.
They have the goods.
Snap to Lawrence as he taps.
Like that. I mean, the tight end I needed. I needed Arnold to block Murray there, but it worked out. Works out more than what I thought it was going to be honest. Oh, he's still on his feet somehow. A yard.
It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up 2nd and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play call, 4 yards for a touchdown. Sequence now. Instead of coming right back,
it's down to the one. Genuinely thought he had it.
Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on 3rd and goal. Robinson.
That should do it. There it is. Robinson rushes for a touchdown.
You can say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit
through
half time.
2nd and 3. Now we'll go 1st and 18.
Let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
2nd and 3 is easy for them. Send them back.
To throw is Watson.
And that's a sack.
He's going to be brought down.
Josh Allen with the sack.
Josh Allen. He's the one that got home and takes it.
Great sack, Josh Allen.
After the sack, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's 2nd and a country mile. Another try after the 1st down sack. Watson out to the flat.
There's a big hit.
And able to get it here.
Big hit for 3rd and 17. Come on, big stop here, defense. Let's go.
Here's Watson. He's letting it fly for Cooks.
It's going to be pass interference on me, isn't it?
However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. Johnson.
My man's just rolling away from him. Jenkins there is just like, nope. Commander, roll away from him.
They'll try again.
Of course he has. And that. Awful call from the officials. Awful call.
Season openers are able to extend their lead. Extra point by Fairbairn up
and I just want to run it because that's working. But 17-34, if I'm going to stand any chance, and it's slim, I get that. I mean, it's slim. Supermodel slim that I'm getting back into this game.
They did what they had to do to start this 3rd quarter. Went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started.
How's that not pass interference? He literally blocked him from running. But no, we'll just get sacked. That's fine. That's not a problem. But Houston goes down the field. Yeah, cool. Yeah, we'll call that. Don't worry. You failed, but we'll call it. Don't worry. Chenault breaking the tackle. Starting to sound a little bit salty here, and I am a little bit, got to be honest, about that pass interference call. I thought it was utter nonsense. And there's Robinson up the middle. Huge yard gain there.
Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete. Every time I see James Robinson make a run, as we just saw there, one word comes to mind for me, and that's determined.
Give me a decent play here.
Undrafted, out of Illinois State, always doubted.
Jones Jr. beating his man would be perfect. That's it, Lawrence. That's it, Lawrence. That's it, Marvin Jones. Let's go. Let's go, baby. That's how it's done. Beat his man off the line. Trevor Lawrence just stepped up in the pocket and went, yes, I'm having it. And launched it deep. And Marvin Jones Jr., the one-handed bring-in. You absolute beauty. Here we go. See if we can not get a pass interference call. See if we can stop this defense. Maybe he's trying to get a three and out here. But I'll call Miles Jack to blitz so they think he's coming. And then I'm going to drop him straight back into coverage. And he's just rolling at the feet of Johnson.
Individual play, we just saw the defense finally win a win.
Yeah, they finally got one, and that's a win for them. But all game long, he's seen the holes, and they've been huge for him.
Roughing the passer, let me guess. The ball seems big. Yeah, because I've stopped them, because it's third and seven. No, we're going to... Do you know what? I want to see that, because these roughing the passer calls are coming right when they need them. So let's have a look. Wow, that's a rough in the passer. He hasn't even tackled him. He hasn't put him on the deck. That's awful. That's awful.
Players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration. Not a good play.
That's it. Oh, I'm fuming at that call, because that's just ridiculous. Not going to lie, I'm struggling now because my head's gone, because I'm just so annoyed at that call, because that's awful. I do think that's an absolute atrocious call. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe that's just me. But I think that's woeful to have that called as a... Yeah, my man, I guarantee my man hit him and knocked him over, and that isn't a foul. Let's have a look. Let's see if this get... Because this isn't pass interference. Pass interference. This isn't... That's not roughing the passer, but walking past him is. The likes of that roughing the passer call, I think, was just absolute nonsense. I don't know how that gets called, and that's inaccurate, even though he's wide open and there's no pressure. Trevor Lawrence can't be getting inaccurate like that. Just can't. Ah, Trevor's going to go on a run. And slide. That'll do. We'll get nice big...
Some early fireworks from this
big yardage.
Getting the start in week one.
And every time a rookie quarterback gets the start week one, you and I both know the extra attention that comes with it. We know that he's going to throw the football, but will he make the right decisions? And in this case,
it's got to be. I bet it's a hold on us.
There's an extra dynamic to his game.
Of course it is. My man's running along like this, up with his arm out, holding my receiver.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar.
But yeah.
And the flag came out. Penalty against him.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Here's Lawrence to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep.
Boat picked. But no pass interference there. Which was exactly what my guy did. But no pass interference. Of course not. Sounds like I'm complaining. I'm not complaining. I would have lost this game, I believe. I do think I would have lost this game regardless.
Absolutely.
Throw that away.
Like you said, but they can maybe take something positive out of this one. And he'll toss this one incomplete.
Yeah, I think I would have lost this game anyway.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
I just think
here's Lawrence. Escaping the pressure run.
That one roughing the passer call that I looked at and that fourth interception, I think.
So that a nice throw, but it hasn't really turned out to be the grand
I just think is ridiculous.
So what have you seen, CD?
About what I expected, really, because for a youngster making his first start in the NFL, I kind of expected to see these things.
And we got that first down conversion.
Expect to see or want to see. But remember, he's not going to the Hall of Fame off this first start. It's going to be an accumulation of games before we have a fully accurate reading.
We'll go for a run on this one. No, because my Norwell's running off away from his blockers, but it is what it is at the end of the day. Like I said, I don't think I was going to win this game. I think the first quarter saw to that. Yeah, the first quarter saw to that, but all I can do is hopefully bring it down to a bring it down to a 10-point game.
They face a third down now as they try to find a late score.
As Trevor Lawrence is going to go for a run. Don't take the hit. That'll do. Down to the 8. Well done, Lawrence. Try and get it down to 10-point game.
But we're unable to do so. He gets away, picks up a big first down, and sets
and see.
Up first and goal inside the 10.
Looking to throw, Lawrence.
Oh, I should have run after the catch.
At the 3-yard line. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Literally at the goal line. Goal line.
But still good yardage. Second down and goal, Lawrence.
That's intercepted.
And it's intercepted at the goal line.
Because I completely missed the open zone that I had at the time and threw it far too late.
And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, 5 interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
And that's the game.
Based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a 5th interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because
five picks.
Need to get him out and find another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
Don't even know why they're running it. I mean, they can see I'm not. Talk about Pat Stadden. I mean, they can see I'm not even calling timeouts. Do I really want to look at the stats? I mean, 247 passing yards,
so for the Texans, that'll be
a touchdown, 5 picks. Robinson had 66, Etienne at 28, Lawrence 55.
For the Jaguars, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll have a tough one at home next week.
Steven Schnell with 73. It was a bad game where their line was able to dominate ours. So work to be done. Work to be done. But we knew that. We knew that going in. So it's not all that surprising. Yes, I'm a little bit annoyed about the penalties, but we ignore those. Let's get some upgrades going. His traits hidden. No. In a strong arm from him. But yeah, he's a rookie. We try, like I said, our rushing, our defense isn't great, our offense isn't great. It's a rebuild. It's exactly what it is. Which is fine. That's what we're in for. He's out for 4 weeks. Happy days. Yeah, he's out for it. It's a rebuild. It's going to be a tough year. Maybe it's four wins was optimistic. But we do it. We'll have a quick chat with one of our leaders about that game that was poor. So yeah, he's glad I gave him a vote of confidence. But yeah, we'll iron it out. We'll get there in the end. Doesn't matter. We'll get there in the end. And talking about QB1. No, he didn't, but it's not going to, yes, isn't going to define our season or his career. So we're okay with it. It's, as the headline says, it's just the beginning. It's just the beginning. And let's get some staff points done. It's just the beginning of this season. When you have to see what some talent trees make you select a pass. This is where I want to get to down the bottom here, because this one helps makes trades a lot easier. So this is the one I'm gonna focus on first, so that I can get myself moving on. Yeah, we'll get the 2% trade value increase. But yeah, the draft is where we're going to be doing a lot of our business. The draft is going to be really important to us. So working that side of the personnel tree where we can get extra value for our draft picks, making it easier to trade and move up or get better players. That's what we're going to need. So that's what I'm going to focus on with the staff points. So yeah, that's it. A disappointing loss. And we've got the Denver Broncos next week. Skip ahead to that week, but yeah, we've got the Denver Broncos next week, who are 1-0, who are around about the same as us. See how we match up after that Texans game. I might alter the slider slightly for the roughing the passer, because I just feel, certainly the one that I looked at, I felt was harsh. Maybe it's me being wrong. Maybe it's me just being salty because I lost, which I'll admit can be completely plausible. But for now, thank you for watching. I know I'm not the most entertaining to listen to, but if you did enjoy this episode, please do subscribe. Hit the notification, the little bell for the notifications for when the next episode's up, and hopefully see you all back for the next episode of this Jags Rebuild where we take on the 1-0 Denver Broncos.